FBC kids, and welcome back to our series called In the Beginning. Now, we started last week about talking what was there in the beginning, and we learned that God has no beginning and he has no end, which means he's been there forever and he's gonna be there forever for us. So I wanted to talk a little bit this week about what we call creation, which would be the creation, the beginning of the world, though. Are you ready to hear about that? So let's think about some things that are on the world, okay? What are some things, maybe some animals, some plants, some really cool things that are in our world? What are some things that you know of? Those are some good things. What about the ocean? The ocean's one of my favorite places. The ocean and the beach, I love that place. Sharks are some of my favorite animals, and dolphins and octopus are so cool. Have you ever seen a whale? It's massive. So cool. Now let's think about some animals that don't live in the ocean, okay? We have kangaroos, or maybe lions, tigers, alligators. Have you seen some of these awesome birds that fly in the sky? They're so different. You have a parakeet, or maybe a parrot or a canary that comes in all these beautiful bright colors. Then you have eagles and hawks and owls that come in these darker browns and blacks and with white feathers. I don't know if you've ever seen the ducks at the ponds, but some ducks are black and brown and white, and I was just talking to someone the other day who has ducks that's gonna have purple on their feathers. Animals come in all different colors and varieties, and they live in all these different places, right? God made some pretty creative and unique things, right? And there are lots of people who have different ideas about where the earth came from and how all the animals and the plants and the people got on it, but today we're gonna learn how it actually happened, the truth. And the truth comes from our Bible. We're gonna start in Genesis in just a minute. If you want, while we're reading our story from Genesis, our Bible lesson this week, you can go grab maybe some Legos or some Duplos, pipe cleaners, aluminum foil, Play-Doh. Maybe if you have modeling clay, if you have a big arts area in your house like I do, you might have a different variety of things. While we're talking today, maybe you could take the time to build, make, craft, create, paint, or decorate something that's part of creation, something that's God's made, and we know that God made everything. And when we're finished, maybe we'll talk about it in just a little bit too, okay? So maybe go ahead and grab your supplies. I'm gonna go grab the Bible and we're gonna get started. All right, so if you've got your materials all ready to build something from creation, to create, craft it, paint it, draw it, however you wanna do it, I'm gonna read from Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 25, all right? In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth was formless and empty, and darkness covered the deep waters, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the surface of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good. Then he separated the light from the darkness, and God called the light day and the darkness night. And evening passed and morning came, marking the first day. Then God said, "Let there be space between the waters to separate the waters of heaven from the waters of earth." And that is what happened. God made this space to separate the waters of the earth from the waters of the heaven. And God called the space sky. And evening passed and morning came, marking the second day. Then God said, "Let the waters beneath the sky flow together into one place so that dry land may appear." God called the dry ground land, and the water seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the land sprout with vegetation, every sort of seed-bearing plant and trees that grow seed-bearing fruit. And these seeds will then produce the kinds of plants and trees from which they came." And that is what happened. The land produced vegetation, all sorts of seed-bearing plants and trees with seed-bearing fruit, and their seeds produced plants and trees of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. And evening passed and morning came, marking the third day. Then God said, "Let lights appear in the sky to separate the day from the night. Let them be signs to mark the seasons, the days, and the years. Let these lights in the sky shine down on the earth." And that is what happened. And God made two great lights, the larger one to govern the day and the smaller one to govern the night. He also made the stars. God set these lights in the sky to light the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from darkness. And God saw that it was good. And evening passed and morning came, marking the fourth day. Then God said, let the waters swarm with fish and other life. Let the skies be filled with birds of every kind. So God created great sea creatures and every living thing that scurries and swims in the water and every sort of bird, each producing offspring of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply. Let the fish fill the seas and let the birds multiply on the earth. And evening passed and morning came, marking the fifth day. Then God said, let the earth produce every sort of animal, each producing offspring of the same kind, livestock, small animals that scurry along the ground, and wild animals. And that is what happened. God made all sorts of wild animals, livestock, and small animals, each able to produce offspring of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make human beings in our image to be like us. They will reign over the fish in the sea, the birds in the sky, and the livestock, all the wild animals on the earth, and the small animals that scurry along the ground. So God created human beings in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. Then God blessed them and said, be fruitful and multiply, fill the earth and govern over it, reign over the fish in the sea, the birds in the sky, and all the animals that scurry along the ground. Then God said, look, I have given you every seed-bearing plant throughout the earth and all the fruit trees for your food. And I have given every green plant as food for all the wild animals, the birds in the sky, and the small animals that scurry along the ground, everything that has life. And that is what happened. Then God looked over all that he made, and he saw that it was very good. And evening passed and morning came, marking the sixth day. Now I want you to think about your favorite thing in creation. It could be the mountains, or maybe like me, it's the beach, the forest that has all those trees, the lake with the calm waters. Maybe it's the beautiful night sky or waterfalls. There's some waterfalls that are, they're huge, they're massive. It's amazing. There are so many beautiful things in creation, and everything that we see, every mountain, every star, every animal, every plant, it all came from God. And that's the story that we read today from our Bible, telling us the true way that the world was created. Everything came from God, and he spoke it all into existence. Do you remember any of the specific things that we heard in our story? Some of the names of the things that he created, or which days he created them on? Well, we're going to work together through the days and figure out what was created on which day, okay? So on the first day, he made the light and the darkness, the heavens and the earth. Do you think of maybe you could find a way to remember that? Maybe the darkness and the light, that would be day one. Maybe you could put your finger up like this and flick on the light like a light switch. That'd be pretty cool, right? On the second day, he made the water and the sky. So he actually separated the water and the sky. So maybe that's your day two, is he separated the water and the sky. Now on the third day, he made dry land and plants. Now this one might be a little bit harder, but maybe you could put three fingers up and go dry land, plants. Could you remember that? Dry land and plants. That was on the third day. On the fourth day, he made the stars, the sun, and the moon. Okay, so now we have four. Sun, moon, and a few stars over here. How about that? Could you remember it over there on that fourth finger? Now we are on day number five. Do you remember what happened on day number five? Okay, so he made the fish. So take your five hand and swim it along, and he made the birds. Awesome job. So that's day number five. On the sixth day, God created a lot of things. Do you remember what he created on that day? So God made all the animals, and he made the first two people, and he made them, and the Bible tells us, in our image. Now we learned last week, let's talk about this real quick, that Jesus was right there at the beginning of everything with God, right? In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. So we know that Jesus is there in the beginning. So when God says we created them in our image, he's talking about God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. So God the Son is Jesus. So that's the Holy Trinity. We're going to talk about that throughout the next couple of weeks as well. So, sixth day, he created all the animals, and he created Adam and Eve. And maybe you could act out the people. So what did God say about everything that he created? This is one of my favorite things about creation. At the end of each day, it says God saw what he created, and it was God created amazing, awesome, good things. What are some things that God created that you might consider to be good? Okay, I think definitely penguins. Penguins are good, right? What are some other things? Some stingrays. I personally don't care for snakes, but since they're part of creation, God created them and they were good. On the seventh day, and we didn't actually get this far into our verses, so this might be a bit of a tricky question for you. God did something that was really important. Does anyone know what it is? God rested. Why do you think God rested? Do you think he was tired? He created this whole world and the solar system and everything into existence. Do you think he was tired? I personally don't think he was tired. I think he did it to show us what we should do, that we should take time to rest and be thankful for everything that's created, and we should appreciate creation. I think God did it to show us that sometimes we gotta take some time off. We gotta make sure that we're focused on the right thing, which is God, and we gotta be thankful for what we have. So God shows us on the seventh day, it's important to take some rest and to appreciate that everything that God has given us, and to be thankful for what he's created, and to praise and worship him. Pretty cool, right? What is something that you've learned about how the world works? Is there something like really cool that you found out about how the world works? Think about the things maybe you've learned in school or in science class. What is something that's so interesting about how nature works? Do you have something that comes to mind? It could be something like how rain actually comes from clouds. How does the water get back up there? How the earth orbits the sun, how the animals protect themselves, how plants grow their own seeds to then drop them into the ground, be blown by the wind, and grow more plants that then grow their own seeds, get blown by. It's amazing, isn't it? Or how maybe oxygen makes its way into our lungs and keeps us alive. What about, oh my goodness, there's just so much. One of my favorite things I love this about. So the earth is in space and the sun's right here, okay? So the earth is at the perfect distance. If we were any further away from the sun, we would freeze. If we were any closer to the sun, we would burn. So the planet that we're on, in the order of the planets in the solar system, is the perfect spot. If we were one planet over or one planet further, or even if we were moved out of our own orbit, we wouldn't be able to survive on this planet. Do you think God made that exactly how it needed to be? I think so too. God created all the places and the things that we love about this world, and there are a lot of things to love. The oceans and the beaches, the forests and the mountains, and everything that you've learned about how the world works, God created it exactly that way. It's like perfect. But I get confused sometimes because people think the world just kind of like and creative. It's confusing, isn't it? It's sometimes hard. There's a verse in Hebrews chapter 11, and I want us to talk about it today because it kind of helps us to understand why we believe and we know that God created everything. Hebrews 11 verse 3 says, "By faith, we understand that the entire universe was formed at God's command, that what we now see did not come from anything that can be seen." So what we can see now with our eyes didn't come from anything that we can see with our eyes. By faith, we understand that God created the whole universe. Sometimes it's hard to just trust and faith, right? But the Bible even answers that question for us of why we should believe. We believe because we have faith that God created it. It's faith is knowing and believing that even if we don't see something, that whole creation story takes faith on our part, because we weren't there to see it. If we were, we would be very, very, very old. And I don't want to be very, very, very old like that, do you? But from the Bible, we learn that all of creation was spoken into existence by God who has always existed. Remember, we learned that last week, that God doesn't have a beginning and he doesn't have an end. He's like that hula hoop. It's just around and around. There's no stopping God. Some people don't believe it's like that, and that kind of breaks my heart a little bit, that they don't have that exciting, awesome faith to believe in God. So how can we know that it's true that God created everything? None of us can go back and watch a video of someone at creation taking a video going, "This is how the world was made." It's not gonna happen. We see evidence of God all throughout creation, though, and when it comes down to it, it takes faith to believe that God created the whole world. And we can have faith that God created everything because we can believe what the Bible says is true, and the Bible is telling us, and we know that God created the whole world. In fact, that's our big idea for this week. Well, I hope you don't think that we're just gonna skip over worship time, because I think worship goes perfectly with absolutely everything that we're doing, but it especially works today because I want us to worship and thank God for this amazing world that He's created. And we know that God created it because we have faith to believe what the Bible tells us. So let's go worship and praise and thank God for this amazing world. In fact, let's thank God for something.
It's not what you don't have, but what you do. I must admit that I forget that life's a gift. Hey mama, gonna change my attitude. 1, 2, 3, 4, count my blessings. 1, 2, 3, 4, count my blessings. If you got a lot or a lot of nothing, like this.
floor, so stomp your feet like this.
Here we go!
Everybody's so
happy.
Yeah, sing it loud, come on, sing it loud. If you're happy and you know it, then I know you want to show it. So sing it loud like this.
Sing it out.
If you're happy and you know it, then I know you want to show it. So do all three like this.
Come on now.
Can you help me with some discussion questions before we close in a word of prayer? How did God create the world? Do you remember what he did? He used his words and he spoke it into existence. What does the creation story tell you about what God is like? Oh man. Well, I just love the fact that he created like the oceans and the water before he created the ocean animals. Do you think that kind of tells us a little bit about what God is like? He's pretty smart, right? Probably wouldn't have been a good idea to create all the animals before they had a home to live in. God knows so much, doesn't he? He knows everything. How pretty cool is that, though, that he has his perfect plan laid out? What did God make first, and what did he make last? So what did he make first? You remember he flicked on the switch, and in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth, right? That's where we live, on the earth. And then he added some light, get rid of the darkness. And what did he make last? Us. He made the people. And he also made the animals, the land animals, on the last day. What do you think God's favorite part of creation was? I don't have an exact answer for you, so maybe you can pick one for you. Why do you think that would be God's favorite part of creation? What's your favorite thing God created? I think I'm gonna have to go favorite thing God created. Favorite thing God created. People, it's you guys. I am so thankful that God created us to spend time with each other and get to know each other. You guys are some of my favorite things God created. Will you join me in a word of prayer as we close? Now, as I pray, I'm actually going to go through the 6 days of creation and thank God for the things on each day that he created. Maybe you could join me, add your own favorite things. I'll tell you what the day is and I'll thank God for it. And then maybe I'll give you some time to also thank God for it, okay? So will you join me in a word of prayer? Heavenly Father, I thank you for this time to join together in worship and praise, Lord, that our church may gather. It's not about where we are, Lord, it is about what we're doing, and we are gathering to worship and praise you, Lord. I thank you for this story of creation to just remind us of your awesome power, Lord, that nothing that is created has not come from you, Lord. Heavenly Father, I thank you for that first day where you created the heavens and the earth, the place that we call home, Lord. And it's full of my favorite things. Heavenly Father, I thank you for what you created on the second day, Lord. The sky and the earth, Lord, that you separated and you created this home for us that we can live and make our choices to love and follow you, Heavenly Father. Lord, I thank you for that third day where you created the seas and the land and the plants. The oceans are some of my favorite things, Lord, and it is so magnificent to see your power and your beauty reflected in creation. Lord, I thank you for what happened on that fourth day, the sun, moon, and stars, Heavenly Father, that just reflect your power and your glory, Lord, that the sun can give us beautiful sunshine to enjoy the day, and the moon can guide us at night, Lord, that the stars twinkle and shine and just bring a smile to our faces. Lord, that fifth day, the fish and the birds, Lord, the ocean animals are some of my favorites, and I thank you for just the enjoyment of these awesome things that you've created, Heavenly Father. Lord, I thank you for the sixth day, especially, Lord, because that's the day that you created us, your children, Lord, that we can worship and praise, thank you, and glorify you with our actions, our words, and our thoughts, Lord, that we can fill with love and compassion for others, to be there for one another, to support and fellowship, Lord. I thank you for this beautiful creation and every item and tiny little detail that you put perfectly together to glorify and praise you, Lord. I thank you for this time of worship, for these families that have set aside time to worship you, Lord, and I ask that you bless them abundantly. In your holy and precious name, I pray. Amen. All right, guys, I hope you have a fabulous week, and I will see you later. But maybe I could tell you a little bit something first. Okay, so we decided for VBS this year that we're actually gonna take the whole month of July to celebrate God's amazingness, okay? So every Wednesday night in July, on our Facebook and our YouTube page, we're going to have our VBS video. So some singing, some dancing, some arts, some crafts. Make sure you stay tuned on our Facebook page, FBC Kids, because I will send out a craft and supply list before Wednesday night so you can go ahead, gather, maybe print some materials and some activities, and probably definitely some crafts. I think we're definitely gonna need some crafts, okay? So like our Facebook page, stay tuned on our YouTube page, and more information will come, but VBS this year is virtual, it's online, and it's gonna be every Wednesday night in the month of July. So I hope to see you there. But in the meantime, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and guess what? It was perfect, it was good. He saw it and it was good. I hope you guys have an amazing week, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.